Previously on the Bible. In the beginning, God created heaven and earth. Then human failings led him to destroy his creation.
Wrong choices, wrong decisions.
After Noah, a new beginning and a promise for Abraham.
God has spoken to me.
He will lead us to a new home. He has promised descendants as numerous as the stars.
But enslaved by Egypt, Abraham's descendants suffered. Until a new leader emerged, who would become Israel's greatest hero.
Who are you? My name is Moses.
God has sent me to set you free.
Freedom! They're free to choose! Slavery or death!
All my life, I have been Pharaoh's. I will never be a slave again.
Joshua, God is with us.
Has delivered us from slavery. We're going to live in the promised land.
Abraham's dream is our future.
You are our future now, Joshua. You must take the land promised to Abraham.
Moses has led the Israelites to the edge of the promised land. Under Joshua, they must conquer it.
Lord, I was with Moses when you handed down these commandments. I was witness to the covenant, the promise of a holy nation. Help me to forge that nation, to lead your people, to inherit their land.
Joshua!
The Lord brought us out from Egypt. He promised us this land. Soon, it will be ours. Come.
Are you ready?
We'll search the whole city.
Just find me a way in. We must take Jericho. It's all that stands between us and the Promised Land.
Can attack at any time.
Rahab, my little whore. What are you doing out? You know it's not safe.
Safe enough.
No one is safe.
I can look after myself.
Go home.
the ground!
I promise I won't hurt him. Swear.
You're Israelites.
You've heard about us?
You have a God who commands the winds and parts the seas.
He saved us from slavery. We are his chosen.
This whole city is terrified of you. How can we fight a people whose God can do that?
Open up! Open up!
Back inside!
Open the door!
Can we get out that way? Help us and we will help you.
Go. I'll store them if I can.
Come with us.
I can't. My family.
When our army comes, hang this on your door so they will know not to harm you. You'll be passed over.
Tell me, did you find a way in? Is there a weakness?
Not in the walls. But in their hearts. Joshua, we met a woman. She thinks God has taken the city already. The people melt in fear because they know he is with us.
God is with us. But we've still to find a way in. My old friend, what would you do? Lord, when I was a slave, you showed me your love and your power. Given me new life. Would you have us turn back? Who are you? I pray you are with us and not with our enemies.
I'm with God, commander of the Lord's army.
What does he ask of us?
The Lord parted the waters for Moses. You.
Ah!
split rock. This is what you must do. March around the city once a day with all the armed men. Do this for 6 days. Carry the Ark with you. It contains God's commandments, and He is with you. Then, on the seventh day, march around the city 7 times. Then the priests should make a long blast with the ram's horn. As soon as you hear the sound of the trumpet, all the people shall shout a great shout. Prostitute and her family may be spared. For God said she must be spared for the help she gave us.
A 100 years after Joshua, the 12 tribes of Israel have spread out across the Promised Land. But hostile neighbors surround them. Better armed and better trained, the Philistines are the deadliest threat. Without great leaders like Moses or Joshua to unite them, the Israelites must rely on local heroes called judges. People like Samson.
Mother, come.
this all stop?
I don't know.
You must fight them. It's what God wants you to do, Samson. It's why God created you. Remember what his messenger told me.
Don't be afraid. Though you are barren, God will give you a son.
Thank you.
Listen carefully. There are conditions. See to it that you drink no alcohol and eat nothing unclean. And when your son is born, his hair must never be cut. This will be the sign that the boy is a Nazarite. He is given to God. From his birth to his death, he will begin to deliver Israel from the Philistines.
Your strength comes from God. Your duty is to drive the Philistines away.
Instead of fighting the Philistines, Samson falls in love and marries one.
Let me talk to her.
Of course.
Mother, does love not come from God? What would you have me do? Reject the woman I fell in love with just because she's a Philistine?
Will your love protect us from them?
We need to send these Israelites a message, make it clear to them. They cannot take our women. Our people should never mix.
How are we going to get to him?
We're not going to get to him.
Open up!
Where's Samson?
I don't know.
Where is he?
He's not here.
Do it!
Please! No!
You are a disgrace to our people.
Please!
Please, I beg you!
Please! Father!
Don't hurt her!
Father! No! 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 Please! Please, I'm begging you, no! Please, no!
For my wife.
One man did this.
Where is he? His people must know. You!
You will bring Samson to me, and you will do it quickly. And for every day I do not see him, one of you will die. Starting now.
No, 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 please, please, no!
Samson?
Samson. Are you there?
Mother. I wasn't expecting you. Forgive me.
We have come to reason with you, Samson.
Reason?
You must stop the killing. Please. For every Philistine you kill, two more appear, seeking revenge.
As they do to me, so I have done to them.
The Philistines are our rulers now.
Everyone must do what they think is right.
No, Samson. You must do what is right for your people. For God, not for yourself. You must give yourself up, Samson.
Mother, is this what God wants?
I'm not sure. Sometimes God leads us in ways we cannot see. God will guide your choices.
All I see is a common murderer.
No worse than you. Why did you kill my wife?
To teach you and your people a lesson.
I gave myself up to save my people. Will you leave them alone now?
If I had more men, I drive you all back into the wilderness where you belong. I'd happily kill all of you.
Kill him.
Your duty is to drive the Philistines away. God will guide your choices.
My Lord God of Israel, is that you?
Oh!
Is this what you want from me? Guide me, please. Thank you. What is your name?
My name is Delilah.
We have news of Samson. He's got a new woman. Philistine woman.
Another one. What's her name?
Delilah.
I know her. Bring her to me. Beguiling as ever.
What do you want?
Well, let's just have a little talk about Samson. An interesting choice. Not one of us, of course. Why are you with him?
Why do you want to know?
Don't tell me you care about him. Is she in love with him?
Ask him yourself.
He's butchered hundreds of our people.
From man since he's met me.
You really believe that? He will go on killing until we find a way to stop him for good. Where does he get his strength? What's his secret?
I don't know. He won't tell me.
Try to convince him.
Have you seen what he's capable of?
Maybe this will help. Call it danger money. It's all for you. Not now. Not until we know his secret.
God is with me, Delilah. He makes me strong.
What do you mean? God is with you. How does he make you strong?
My mother was barren. God brought her a child. Me. But there are things I must not do.
Such as?
I have never cut my hair. I am forbidden. A sign of my devotion. cut my hair.
What, my love? What if you cut your hair?
My God will take away all my strength. I will be as weak as everyone else. You don't believe me?
No, Samson. I do.
Samson! Take him! What have you done?!
See her again.
Take him away. Something. Lord.
Quiet.
Lord. If I am yours, remember me now. Strengthen me once more.
Your God has abandoned you, Samson.
You are the man who took away my eyes. I am glad of it, for the darkness helps me think.
Your God has deserted you and taken your strength with him.
No. I can see him more clearly than ever. He wants me to destroy you all!
It's over, Samson.
Lord.
Samson's sacrifice kills thousands, but he could never defeat the Philistines on his own. The prophet Samuel has urged the people to unite in God's name.
There is no one like the Lord.
But after decades of struggle, he too has failed to halt the Philistines.
Prophet, we await you.
And the people's patience is wearing thin.
So what is it that troubles you?
We are grateful, Prophet. You have led us for many years.
God has led us.
Samuel, you are not as young as you were.
We are worried.
Who will speak to the Lord after you? Who will lead us against the Philistines?
My sons will inherit my place.
Your sons are corrupt.
My sons have been brought up to trust in God and obey his laws. Everything I've done for you, I have done because I walk in God's ways.
We know that they take bribes. Everyone knows it. They shame your good name. So, when you are gone, and the Philistines return, and we look to your sons to call on God, will God answer? No, he will not.
Then what do you want?
A king. As other nations have.
But look what other nations' kings do. They become tyrants. They make slaves of their people.
Not if they are chosen by God, anointed by his righteous prophet, by you.
You would reject our God. God promised us this land. This is God's kingdom. He is our only king.
You have the ear of the Lord, Samuel. You must ask him to choose a king for us.
Leave me alone. All of you. I have given everything. Now they have rejected me. And you, God. But if you say I should give them a king, then of course I will. But who should it be? Justly and wisely and according to God's law. I anoint you the first king of Israel. And I, as God's prophet, help you in any way I can.
A new era in Israelite history is beginning. The period of prophets and kings. They must work together to secure the Promised Land. Next time on The Bible.
Are the men ready?
They're ready.
We must make a sacrifice before we attack.
May God forgive you. Be a king. Leave the job of priest to me.
You are our prophet. But I am your king.
What the Lord gives, he can take away.
God is with me!
I am with him, Lord. Really? You disobeyed the Lord. He has torn your kingdom from you and given it to David.
Will you have my crown? Will you not kill my descendants? Bury my name!
Jerusalem. A new home.
The king is never above his God. You abused your power.
You took everything from your most loyal servant. You took his wife. Then you took his life.
You think God doesn't see everything?
I am his chosen one.
David, he will bring disaster on your house.
We shall see.